catch me in the trunk. Catch me in the trunk. Catch me in the trunk.
Where the speakers knock.
Catch me in the trunk. Catch me in the trunk. Catch me in the trunk.
Manila.
Where the speakers knock.
Hopi in Manila, we'd like to welcome you to Cafe 808 on SaddySaddySounds.com.
Thank you very much.
Along with Monique of the Hip Hop In Her 101 on who Hopi is and what you do.
Hopi is me. Yeah. I'm an artist from San Francisco, but I was born in Manila. So, you know, this right here is actually my first time ever being back in Manila since I left as a child. You know, and I just got introduced to the entire hip hop scene out here, and it's amazing. I have done 3 albums so far. In 2008, I released The Diamond Dame. And then last year, in 2011, I released Dulce Vida and Raw Gems. And I'm working on another album, just trying to like release as much music as possible. And yeah, that's just basically who I am, just a rapping ass person.
What it feels like to be reconnecting with the roots.
It's been amazing. Like, just the second you land, you know what I mean? You just feel like you're home, which is crazy because, to tell you the truth, I don't remember it that well. I left really early in my life, but now that I'm here, I understand why I feel so connected to it. Mm-hmm. You know, while I was in the States, I was, you know, getting tattoos of the Philippines. Mm-hmm. I have the Philippine Islands tattooed on my back. I have Sampaguita. I have, like, all kinds of different tattoos to commemorate me leaving, but for some reason, you know, like, I never came back and until now, and now I understand, you know, why I've been so drawn to kind of memorializing this this part of my life. It feels great. And to see the hip-hop community in the Philippines makes me really happy because I'm a Filipino, I'm doing hip-hop, and I'm here, and I'm like, oh, shit, I'm home.
Marunong ka naman mag-Tagalog.
Yeah, pero, well, nakakaintindi kong lahat ng Tagalog, pero medyo mabuluktot.
Yeah.
My accent is fucked up.
Space Case.
Yes.
And you worked on it with Del.
How that came about, like?
Well, Del is actually my mentor. You know, he was on my first album, and he was on my third album, and we also are working on an album together. We've been in the studio, and he's always like kind of just been texting me, emailing me, just like letting me know, like, hey, I like this song, I like this video, you know, like, how are you doing, blah, blah, blah. So he's been very instrumental in trying to shape, you know, my music career. But it all actually all came about through MySpace, believe it or not.
You went on a hiatus before putting out Raw Gems.
Yes.
What was that like? Did it fire you up more, or did you have a struggle, like?
Girl, I hated it. I hated it. I was in law school. I was like, damn, you know. But I kept on recording anyhow. Even while I was in law school, I was still recording. I was still performing a little bit here and there. But I really had to focus because, you know, you can't really fuck up. You know, it was really difficult. And that's why as soon as I got out, I was like, man, I am performing and writing all this music.
What was the difference, like, putting together your debut album with your succeeding album?
The first album was very fun, and I'm just trying it out. Like, we'll see what happens. I'm just doing it just to do it. And even if no one listens to it, then no one listens to it. But the second album was very much like, I felt like people were watching. And the second album actually, if I can clarify, is Raw Gems. Because Dulce was while I was recording Raw Gems. And Raw Gems is getting me really frustrated. Because I really felt like, oh my god, I should like live up to this expectation. And there was like a couple months in between where I was like, fuck it. I'm just gonna record another album. And I'm just gonna write it and record it. And I recorded Dulce Vida in a month. I was like, dude, fuck it, I'm just gonna release it and whatever. So between Diamond Dame and Raw Gems, I felt pressure to like live up to some kind of hype. And in between I said, fuck the hype, here's Dulce Vida.
Yeah, fuck the hype.
And it's actually my favorite album I made.
How would you describe, I guess, the hip-hop scene from where you're from?
Well, the Bay hip hop scene is, I feel like it's very similar to the hip hop scene here. It's close knit, it's community oriented. People are really good friends. You know, we share the same kinds of experiences, struggles, and you know, we feel a lot of camaraderie. We're actually really supportive of each other, and I feel like that's what I've been experiencing out here in Manila too.
Hopi is gonna step in the booth and she's gonna drop a live performance of Nop. Turn up your volumes, you know, if you're at work, fuck it, this is safe for work. So bump it hard, here is Hopi with Nop.
Catch me in the trunk, catch me in the trunk, catch me in the trunk.
What the speakers knock.
Catch me in the trunk, catch me in the trunk, catch me in the trunk.
Manila.
What the speakers knock. Catch me in the trunk, catch me in the trunk.
Cafe 808, what's up?
Catch me in the trunk, what the speakers knock. Catch me in the trunk, catch me in the trunk,
catch me in the trunk. What the speakers
knock. Catch me in the trunk, catch me in the trunk,
catch me in the trunk. What the speakers knock. Catch me in the trunk, baby, catch me in the trunk, y'all.
Catch me in the trunk where the speakers
knock. I'm on another level, cool, devil drooling on my treble, but the bass keep them heavy. I'm forever rockin' steady. I better drop them, baby, since the dame Hopi's name set in every tongue a wagon. That's what I'd imagine, that's what I expected when I first hit the deck. When the verse I first let leak seeped into your eardrum. How can I express what I sincerely understood as truth? Motherfuckers never feared a lady till I hit the booth. Destiny's in truth, I knew I had a calling. That's when no one tested me and saw this as appalling. Styling the inevitable is never viable. But you start coming to take a tangent, bands, and never a man of fact came to. Oh, did it hit him a little too hard? Collecting my feet like, oh god, I buy some lip flex hard off. Maybe I'm too different to stomach. 5'100", fucking six fingers, hope he's better coming. You love it.
Catch me in the trunk, catch me in the trunk, catch me in the trunk.
What the speakers
knock.
Catch me in the trunk, catch me in the trunk,
catch me in the trunk. What the speakers knock.
So post, cause I'm supposed to be the illest. Chillin' at my post atop the tippy of the summit. Bumpin', slumpin', I'm Hopi, have you heard? Too busy for the sucker, so I duck and flip the bird. Word, swerve, out the way, never skirt. Past the gates, smack the way I came, cause then half past the game. A virtuoso, too verbose, toes I'm coming in. Sizing up the victims for the kill, I hope you listening. Here's a play-by-play, so take some notes, I'm feeling dissident. Saying that I shine is undermining, not fake listening. Missing in the game, a chick who ain't resort to sex appeal. That's reveal the weaponry, six fingers is a man of steel. Hopi raps are venomous and that's a checklist. And the rest is just what happens when you add the best ingredients. Really, it's a miracle if we ever could really stop. Not your hitter, we compliance, I am Hopi and I
catch me in the trunk, catch me in the trunk, catch me in the trunk.
Where the speakers knock. Catch me in the trunk,
catch me in the trunk,
catch me in the trunk. Where the speakers
knock.
And that was Hopi live. Woo! Here on Cafe 808 on SaiSaiSounds.com with Nop.
What is your advice on how you can put yourself out there the right way? How have certain like networking sites served you?
You know, as an independent hip hop artist, you know, it's a struggle if you want to get it put on. The main obstacle is yourself. You just have to be goal oriented and you have to be driven and know what the fuck you want, you know? And if you are focused enough, then you'll go ahead and realize that certain outlets are out there for you. There's MySpace from back then. Now it's more like Facebook, Twitter, Tumblr, YouTube, all that stuff. You know, use it to your advantage. There's a lot of people out there and they're trying to get the same kind of attention that you are, but if you are self-actualized, then you understand what makes you unique as an artist and you just keep on honing that, you know? And if you're truly unique and you're truly talented and you understand, you know, what it is that makes you the kind of artist that you are, then I feel like, you know, your avenues are there. You know, I'm still struggling myself as an independent artist to try to, you know, make my mark in the music world, but I feel very happy and blessed to just even have the fan base that I do have. And you know, if this is where it ends or this is the pinnacle of it all, then it's more than I could really have ever asked for.
And you were talking about Raw Gems, your latest album, as an experiment.
Yes.
The vibe was very outer space on that album. Was that really like your vision to take Raw Gems towards that direction?
Well, you know what? The thing with Raw Gems is that and all the art, all the albums that I do, is it's very organic. I don't try to funnel it into any one particular sound. Raw Gems is the third album I've done with Six Fingers, who has been my longtime producer. He actually found me, you know. He went out and he scouted me in 2007, and we've been working together ever since. So Raw Gems is a culmination of our chemistry together in the studio.
Wishful thinking, like your dream collaborations.
Andre 3000!
That was quick. That was pretty quick.
Andre 3000, oh my god, if he's in the Philippines. Anywhere in the world, please.
Being a female MC,
yes.
Is that more of an advantage, a disadvantage when it comes to hip-hop, or at least from the scene you're in?
I want to say that's a disadvantage, just because there's not a lot of female MCs,
yeah.
And then hip-hop is a very misogynistic medium of art. It's very inherently prejudicial towards us. But at the same time, you know, the fact that I'm a female MC has gotten me a lot of love, because people are really interested in the fact that I'm a chick, you know what I mean? And a lot of women, you know how people have this misconception, I guess, or there's a stereotype that women are always competitive and they don't like each other. The thing is that the women have probably been the most supportive of me, and other female MCs have been very supportive. So, you know, you could take it either way, just like anything else in life. You could take it as like a disadvantage, or you could see it as a challenge that you've risen above, and it could be something very positive in your life. And I said, that's how I feel about it.
What do you feel about that? Those female rappers, I don't even think you would call them MCs, that do the sexy thing, that talk about get with
sex.
Me and yeah.
Well, the way I see it is, to each their own. You know, if you find strength in your sexualism, in your sexuality, I should say, then that's great. That's good for you. You know, you are your own person. Everyone's an adult, and you know, sex is part of our lives, and if that's where you garner your strength from, good for you. Mm-hmm. Personally, being hypersexualized, for me, it doesn't suit me very well. You know, I was raised by my dad, and I feel uncomfortable, you know, being extra sexual and kind of selling my music based on that kind of imagery. Mm-hmm. You know, if you're an MC, you're an MC, and that's just a stand on its own. Whether or not you're wearing a short skirt and high heels, or you're wearing some baggy jeans and a backwards hat. You know, it's up to you. You just have to do what's right for you, and you have to do what you feel best represents you. And what best represents me may not always be the most sexy, but I think sexy is being you.
Once again, it's HarrySaiSounds.com, the Hip Hop In Her, and Soul Sonic TV. All connecting, all for Hopi. We out. In all the rings, and everybody want a piece of hope. Want a piece of hope. What they don't understand is I've been chilling on the fringe, outskirts since birth, where I work best. No, with her.